Welcome to Massive Mixtape, the greatest music review show in the world. Now your hosts, Mark and Carol.
Well, hello everyone. Welcome back to the Mixtape. It's me, Mark, alongside, as always, my girlfriend, Carol. How you doing, Carol?
Hey, what's up?
Today is October 30th, 1994. It's the Devil's Night. Lots of fires in Detroit. Remember, those the devotees of the show will remember that we did the Crow, and this is Crow Night.
Yeah.
Now, it's Angels Night and Crow Night. So, if you get murdered tonight...
Don't get murdered.
Be heartened by the fact that you might come back as the Crow.
Yes, let's all think about that for a minute.
But we're not here to talk about murder or crows. We're here to talk about two new songs, one from the Hot 100, one from the Billboard 100, one from the Alternative 100. I said that four times.
You okay over there?
Yeah.
A couple too many birthday drinks yesterday, by the way. Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. It was my birthday yesterday.
Getting to be an old man.
I am. But the first song that we're going to do is from the Smashing Pumpkins. It's the holiday spirit. Smashing Pumpkins.
Smash some pumpkins.
They did a... Maybe one of those pumpkins will come back as the Crow.
That would be weird.
They did a cover of the Fleetwood Mac song Landslide. So take a listen to Landslide. Slide by the Smashing Pumpkins.
Oh, why?
I had to do one. I didn't do one last week at all. I spoke normally the entire week.
That's all I have to say. What is wrong with you?
Carol, what do you think of the Smashing Pumpkins' rendition of Landslide?
I love it. I think I actually like it better than the Fleetwood Mac version.
I do not.
No?
No. I think it's fine. It's a fine version of the song, but I think Stevie Nicks' Fleetwood Mac version is the superior version, in my opinion.
Hmm. I mean, they're both great, but I don't know. My heart is with the Smashing Pumpkins.
Again, like we talked about last week with Nirvana, this is an acoustic version of this song. And I think it aids a little bit. It's another, and they're very similar in different ways. So, we talked about a Girl last week by Nirvana, and how that was one of the better written songs Nirvana's ever done. And I think this, Stevie Nicks was known for being just a fantastic writer, fantastic lyricist. And this is no exception. This is a very, very well-written song. I mean, you talk about imagery, about emotion. It's a very well-put-together song lyrically.
Yeah, and I mean, like, it just pulls on my heart, like, the, you know, getting older and, mm-hmm. you know, just time passing and thinking about life. I mean, it's, yeah.
Yeah, it's clearly about a woman that's in a relationship that she wants to get out of. Which is something Stevie Nicks wrote about a lot in her music.
Was she in an unhappy relationship?
Most of the time, yes. Her and Lindsey Buckingham, who was also in Fleetwood Mac, had a very contentious on-again, off-again relationship.
Okay.
And so, yeah, it's obviously that's what the song's about. Billy Corgan from the Smashing Pumpkins, I think they do bring something to it. I'm not completely dismissing it.
No.
I do think that the Fleetwood Mac version is better. But I think it's funny, too, that Stevie Nicks writes a song basically saying, I'm over you, I'm leaving, and makes Lindsey Buckingham play it.
Right.
Play the shit. That's a power move right there. But, so, you know, I think that is the superior version. But I do think that it's not just a cover. It's not just, let's do the song again in my voice. It's, they do bring something unique to it.
Yeah.
There's a different slant. It's more hopeful than Stevie Nicks's, I think.
Okay.
Stevie Nicks is more of, I mean, it's definitely, it's a very declarative song when Stevie Nicks sings it. It's very much, I'm sick of your shit, and I'm moving on, okay, type of thing. When the Smashing Pumpkins and Billy Corgan specifically sings it, and with it all stripped down and everything again, really letting the lyrics shine through, I think his is more hopeful. It's more, yeah, about the future than it is the past. I think Stevie Nicks' version is about the past, and his version is about the future.
Okay.
That's how I see it.
Interesting.
He's looking at what's coming next.
Okay.
And she's looking at what she's getting away from. That's kind of how I see things. It just in the way they sing it, what they bring to the song, and that's I think the big difference. Hmm. But what did you think of it overall?
Overall, I really enjoyed it.
Well, that's great.
Well, I mean, I've already talked about, like, I like these lyrics, and you've been talking about what it means, and, you know, I mean, I don't feel like there's a ton left to say.
I'm sorry, I dominated the conversation.
No, it's fine. But, yeah, I mean, like, it's an emotional song, and I enjoy it.
Does it speak to you specifically? Like, can you think of a time when one of the losers that you dated before me, you might have said, you know, I'm getting older, I'm moving on, kind of thing.
That's not what this song makes me think of.
Okay, well, what's
I
it
mean,
make
I guess
think
that's
of?
The purpose of the song, but that's not what it makes me think of. It does make me think about, you know, time passing, but to me, it's thinking about, like, the distance in my life from things that have already happened.
Interesting. Okay, I like that.
So, like, I think about things in my childhood and how far away I've come from them.
Wow. Okay. That's a very interesting slant to take on it.
Thank you.
I think it, what?
I said thank you.
You're welcome. But we will move on to the Hot 100 hit, I think, right?
Yes.
This is Hot 100.
Yes.
This is Sarah McLachlan.
Oh my God, Sarah McLachlan.
The Sarah McLachlan group.
It's not a group.
No, there's
Sarah McLachlan.
There was a thing on, I think it was on CNN. It was a political roundtable show in the 1980s, I think the 70s and the 80s, called the McLachlan Group.
Okay.
The Saturday Night Live used to do a bit about it. Anyway, so they're missing a beat if they don't do the Sarah McLachlan Group.
Okay.
But anyway, so this is, what's it called again?
Good Enough.
Good Enough. So let's see if this song's good enough for you.
Hey, your glass is empty. It's a hill of a long way home. Why don't you let me take you? It's no good to go
So that was Good Enough by Sarah McLachlan. I will say, this is the, I mean, not this right now, but listening to the song for this is the first time I've actually heard this song.
Okay.
And I don't dislike Sarah McLachlan, but I just, the song, I mean, the song's relatively new,
mm-hmm,
but I just haven't, a lot of times when we do this, obviously there's songs that I've heard before, especially if they're big, big hits. Then there's song that I've heard before we actually cover them. But I went out of my way to listen to this so that we could talk about it.
Right.
And I really like it, I have to say. I think it's a very good song. It also makes me think that Sarah McLachlan is giving a warning to everybody, I'm going to steal your girl.
What?
That's what you didn't get that?
No.
So, like when she's saying to the girl, you know, he says that it's good enough or whatever. Hey, I'll give you more than good enough.
What?
She's saying, I'll give you more than good enough. Like the boyfriend, you know? Boyfriend's saying, it's good enough. I'll give you more than good enough. Come
Where
over.
Where are you getting that?
Come over here to this lady.
I didn't get that at all.
Oh, well, tell me what the song's about then.
I mean, it's talking about, you know, how you treat people, but it's not, I didn't get the impression she's trying to steal somebody or it's anything about that. I mean, I guess maybe that line, like, hey, little girl, would you like some candy? But in the video, like, there's actually a little girl, so it didn't really occur to me.
Well, let me ask you a question. When she's talking about the good enough and the guy and everything,
mm-hmm.
do you think she's talking about a relationship, like a boyfriend, husband, or do you think she's talking about a dad and daughter relationship?
I think, in the song, I guess I thought it was a boyfriend.
Yeah.
But then you put it to the music video and then everything gets confusing.
It does get a little confusing, but I'm not going to put a lot of stock in the music video because a lot of times the writer of the song, Sarah McLachlan in this case, she might have some input in the music video, but it's not always going to be 100% her vision.
Okay.
When she was writing the song, I don't think she was thinking of a little girl.
But I mean, the don't tell me I've never been there for you, don't tell, you know. I mean, I think that it's an unhappy relationship that she's singing about.
Okay.
For sure.
Yeah, I agree. It's definitely a relationship that's not working.
Yeah.
But is it a dad and daughter? Is it a boyfriend and girlfriend, husband and wife? And who is she in the song then? Is she, if it's dad and daughter, is she the mom? If it's a boyfriend, girlfriend, is she the friend? Is she the have your first lesbian experience with me girl?
What?
Or what? Don't take this from me.
I don't think she was singing about having your first lesbian experience.
Honey. No, I know.
Well, she's saying, don't tell me, I've never been there for you.
Okay.
So, I mean, I think that she's she's like the other partner.
She's the other half of this. So she's singing to herself when she says about being good enough and stuff. She's kind of
simply not good enough.
She's talking to herself saying that, hey, it's not good enough. But doesn't she say, I'll show you good enough or something like that?
Don't think so.
I thought she said something like, I'll show you that good enough's not good enough or something like that.
I don't know. We should really have like the lyrics.
Liner notes.
Yeah.
The songs. Gotta get some liner notes to these songs. But anyway, so yeah, I mean, this one is confusing, but I like it a lot. It's very melodic, obviously.
Yeah.
It's almost a hypnotic song.
Mm-hmm.
And I enjoy the music of it. I like it's a very flowing and makes you kind of feel relaxed. But at the same time, it's still a bit of a downer song, I guess. At least it's got some serious connotations to it anyway.
Yeah. Okay, so I think I found the liner notes.
Oh, okay, you wrote them down?
I found them, yeah.
Okay.
I had written them down. And it's you're so much more than good enough.
Yeah. So she's so...
I'll show you why you're so much more than good enough.
Right, she's talking to somebody else, right?
Yeah.
So I don't know what the relationship is in the song.
Yeah. But she's not saying, I'll show you good enough. She's saying, I'll show you why you're so much more than that.
Yeah, I'll show you why you're so much more than good enough, Carol. Doesn't that sound like I'm gonna steal your girl?
No.
All right.
Not at all.
Okay. So is it a friend giving advice to another friend?
I think it's just someone who cares about someone who's being hurt.
Okay.
Which actually makes sense in the video now, too.
Okay.
Because she's saying, you know, don't tell me I've never been there for you and stuff, but she is there for them, and then there's somebody telling them they're not good enough, and she's saying, I'll show you, you are more than good enough.
No, okay. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. So it's nebulous, the relationship.
Yeah.
But I like the way you put it. It's about somebody that cares about somebody else who's being hurt. Which one of these do you think is better?
It's a toss-up, because, I mean, I like them both a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to go with good enough because Landslide is, remake, yeah.
Or a cover. Yeah. I am surprised.
Yeah?
Yeah, I thought you were going to go with Landslide. I thought it was going to be a rare occasion where we disagree.
Oh. But
I am going to say good enough because, almost for the same reasons, I like the Stevie Nicks version better. Though I do think the Smashing Pumpkins version is very good. I don't think it's a bad song by any stretch of the imagination.
No, not at all.
But I was really taken with this song. And I might listen to some more Sarah McLachlan.
Well, you can certainly borrow my album.
Yeah, I might take you up on that because I really did like this song. And I liked there was a sweetness to it. Even though it was about something that can be, could be considered sad, there was a sweetness to it and like a hopefulness to it, I think, that a lot of these songs lack, and I liked that mentality to it.
I agree.
But anyway, Carol, take us home.
So I really want you people to let us know which one you like best. So, you know, leave me a note in my locker or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And be sure to listen to all the mixtapes and all our 90210s and our main tapes.
All right. Well, you have a good day, everybody. We'll talk to you later. Bye.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. Bye.